state championship basketball where they never won it. Their white school never won it, but they have a champion won it at the North School. So it all depends on who followed that next person that did the hire. That's where, and then to answer that question, that Mr. Ten hired everybody that wanted to be hired, but some didn't want to be hired here.
Why didn't they?
Well, they felt better because they went to predominantly black school down in the Tyler there, you know. And I can think in terms of him, of Brown, I talked with him about it. Why didn't he hire? Because he was a good music teacher. Why didn't you go on at West and all? Yeah, you listen to me play music, I said, but I enjoy it where I'm going. And he went there. So it all depends on, same thing is happening here at Texas A&M. You might have noticed it last year. The lady that, see, we had our first minority, I went to a minority black. We had our first black vice president. And you probably remember this.
Can't forget him. He's fabulous.
Don't you remember that?
And he's now our chancellor, or associate chancellor.
Associate chancellor.
Yes. Yeah. That you're talking about a, what's the man's name?
Frank Ashley.
Frank Ashley. So that's Ashley. So, but you see, Devin McFarland that hired Ashley, see? And but he couldn't keep him there. You want me to say, well, why didn't he stay here? Well, he's down there, he liked it better down there. And he left down there and came up here. And how in the world he ended up going back down there, where he got a better position? And that makes a difference. Then we had a black lady that was vice president. Yeah, you remember the black lady that was vice president? You don't remember her?
Yes, what
is that lady's name? Your death was sister name.
I don't remember.
You remember her name? You remember? She came down here and visited with us there. In fact, she around with us. And she got a job. She went to North Carolina. In fact, I had a letter to show it where she wrote me from North Carolina, ENT. North Carolina black school got the same position she had here, but she was when the next president came and the next president had, they had a fight in their place. Mm-hmm. They had a fight in their place, and so white people got it now. Then we had another black man that was a over. Student, the council of government, and we just knew he was getting his doctorate degree, working on his doctorate degree, and the man came up missing. We wondered about it. We did not know about him because he and I don't want to get him in the Kiwanis Club. And he's a member of the Kiwanis Club, and he could we go out there all the time together, and he left here. And just last year, but they had another white man with a white person hired in that position, and he's gone. So you can see, you never know the piece that takes his place there. That's what you need to go after. You have to go after the people that have been smart. We should have worked closely with the person that's hired the superintendent. But I got on already saying about that because I just couldn't see this lady leaving here because this is the first time we had a lady vice president there. And she was her office next door to McFarland's office. And McFarland was here. McFarland let her get away. I asked Mike Farland about the man, what happened? And he said that she wasn't recommended. you know.
Linda King?
No, not King, not Linda King, Linda King. Secretary, this girl, Linda.
Professor Mathon?
Mm-hmm. Yes, yeah, she's Linda, that's her best. She's the one that didn't recommend it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she was the vice president. She didn't get that job back to either. I'm glad she didn't get it because she knew it would have black. And when she came to the Kiwanis Club, and she spoke at the Kiwanis Club, and I asked her about it during that meeting. Why didn't she hire that lady? And she said, I'll talk to you about it later. Mm-hmm. And that's the last we heard of that. Mm-hmm. So that's, so it all depends on the people that followed with Butch's hiring. His hiring, I think, could really be something.
Were you involved in getting blacks, say, hired at the post office here, or blacks hired maybe in city government or at the...
Bobby Pinnell, and from Bobby Pinnell to this man came to a meeting. It may have been about 3 weeks ago at the North Community. Somebody died down there. He came to the funeral. He was working the funeral on out of Greenville. And I asked him, what happened to him? He said, he's a policeman there. I said, what happened to him? He said, well, say, got a better job, so he left there. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if that's the case or not, but that's all he would tell me. You know, sometimes some people won't tell you because they think you might, especially a guy like Ivory Moore, because I'm going to go jump on back to him. You know, a lot of times things come up, they won't tell me. Okay, well, I don't want to talk about that or something like that, you know. And some people will talk to you about it. The man said, I never get a job if I talk to you about it. Because you're going to go jump them, man. They're going to tell others and that kind of thing.
You've really done a lot to improve the Norris community with helping get money to pave the streets and put in water mains and sewers and work with the Norris Club. What changes other than those have you seen in the Norris community since you've been here in Commerce? And maybe in terms of the people that live there, their attitudes, income. Have there been any changes in the Norris community over the last 30 years or so?
Oh, yeah. Well, I've seen a lot of attitude change. I was talking to a young man that you all know, of course. He's with me when we, last time you had me, Mr. Harry Turner. Yeah. Remember Harry Turner? And he came up, he was there. Harry Turner's daughter, Camille. I don't know whether you all know it or not. When I was running for, city council, every time I'd go down and put my sign up,